Imagine, if you will, a technology skyscraper rising high into the skyline from Florida State College at Jacksonville. That skyscraper is our enterprise architecture for information systems, the blueprint that defines and illustrates the college's technology ecosystem. The strength of our architecture resides with the architect's ability to define and assemble resources on time, on budget, and with collaborative support. And although our technology tower is made up of many different floors, if those floors are not connected for information flow and travel, the entire building can be weakened, unable to stand tall and withstand bad weather. The largest floor houses the Enterprise Resource Planning, or ERP, system. But the ERP isn't the only tenant of this building. Our tower is comprised of a number of different floors, which we refer to as ancillary systems. Let's look at some of these ancillary systems. One floor down from the ERP, we have a data-centric environment, commonly known as data centricity. This centralized data system is necessary for effective communication between the floors of our skyscraper. That is, within the college, between departments, and more. Without data centricity, the people who work in our tower cannot effectively share information from their computers, talk on their phones, or even get from floor to floor using staircases or elevators to meet with coworkers or team members. Next, we find single sign-on, which allows all of our systems to communicate with each other and facilitates identity management. Imagine you're in this long hallway with lots of doors, but you only need one key to unlock all of them. That's single sign-on. It allows users to move easily between systems. Identity management ensures that the systems know who the users are without having to ask again and again. Down below is FSCJ's technology library, also referred to as a data dictionary. A data dictionary is a centralized repository of information describing the data. It is literally data about data. Data owners each have office space on this floor. They may work in other buildings, but each data owner has a right and a responsibility to frequent their office in the technology library. This space is perfect for collaboration and communication via a data governance group or committee. Data owners collaboratively define, design, develop, deploy, and evaluate FSCJ's enterprise data governance policy. On the floor underneath, we find a gym of sorts, a space to strengthen necessary policies, such as risk management, as well as communicating the institution's technology platforms, policies, and procedures. Next up, our bank, where we transform capital expenditures into operating expenditures, adding up to increases in strategic value. Finally, we find a ballroom. This is no ordinary ballroom, however. In it, we find PeopleSoft, our new external cloud-hosted technology, squaring off with our internal technology environment. This is not a fight, however. It's more of a dance. With CITS in the conductor's chair, controlling the pace and tempo of the movements between the interconnected technologies and ensuring that each movement of the dance is carefully planned so the dancers don't step on each other's toes. Let's take a break from our tour now. Step outside and pull out our phones. Maybe check our email or our Twitter account. That mobile phone's a lifeline, isn't it? You can do practically anything on it. That's what we want for our students as well. A complete mobile user experience with the college, where everything works, from paying for classes to finding just the perfect research tool in the online LLC. There's a pretty good view from down here, isn't there? We can see our Enterprise Information Systems Architecture Tower and a few other smaller structures that have popped up along the way, like the Academic Technology Center campus tech building, and an array of ticketing systems. There's a problem here, though. All of these smaller buildings were once part of our skyscraper. And when we start removing pieces of our tower, the systems don't work. You can't make calls because the lines are snapped. You can't use the stairs because there's nowhere to go. So how would we communicate? We could install skywalks between buildings or maybe horizontal elevators. That way we'd still be connected, but just think of the complications and expense. And if we keep pulling pieces out of our tower, one of these days it's simply going to collapse. That's why it's so important that we think long and hard about the details of our new tower before construction begins.